Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our daily current affair based MCQ series. So as is clear from its name, so this series is about your current affair MCQs, in which what we do, we daily discuss 10 MCQs from your current affair perspective. So the MCQs are based upon the current affairs of the particular day. So today is 10 September, so let's see what are the questions for today. So the first question is, Bab al-Mandeb connects which two seas? A. Red Sea and Gulf of Aden, B. Persian Gulf and Arabian Sea, C. Red Sea and Mediterranean Sea, D. None of the above. So friends, there is no point of saying that I think the answer is A, because the answer is shown on your screen. It is clearly A, but let me show you the photograph from where you can get the idea about this. So here is, you can see Red Sea, so this is the region of Red Sea, and here is this Bab al-Mandeb. So Bab al-Mandeb connects this Red Sea and Gulf of Aden. So this is Yemen country, which is a civil war prone country. So its capital is Sana'a, and then these are basically other African countries. So here you can see Strait of Hormuz, so it connects Persian Gulf with Gulf of Oman. So you can see in detail also in your atlas, if in case you have the atlas with you. So mostly the Oxford atlas is recommended for the preparation. So if in case you have, do ensure that you regularly go through it. So because map based questions are frequent in UPSC. Next is second question. Consider the following statements related to Nilgiri Tahar. First, it is endemic to western ghats of India. Second, it is the state animal of Tamil Nadu. So which of the above statements is correct? Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. Yes, it is endemic to western ghats, and it is also state animal of Tamil Nadu. So basically it is listed as endangered, and also it is protected under the Schedule 1 of the Wildlife Protection Act. So the solution is C. So Nilgiri Tahar, here you can see the photograph. So Nilgiri Tahar is also known as Nilgiri Ibex. So it is endangered, and it has been listed under Schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act 1972, which provides it absolute protection and offenses under these are prescribed with highest penalties. So adult males of Nilgiri Tahar species develop a light gray area or saddle on their backs. That's why they are also called saddlebacks, and it is state animal of Tamil Nadu and open mountain. It is basically found in open mountain grassland and endemic to Nilgiri Hills and southern portion of western Ghats in Tamil Nadu, Kerala. And basically threats are habitat loss due to the livestock, this domestic livestock, and spread of invasive plants, and then poaching takes place, and population of these animals are small and isolated, and making them vulnerable to local extinction, and then climate change is also reducing the number of this species. Next is, consider the following statements about Northeastern Council. First, it is a statutory body under the Northeast Council Act of 1971 by the parliamentary. Second, its decisions are advisory in nature. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. Yes, it is a statutory body and its decisions are advisory. So recently this Northeastern Council met. So the solution is C. So you can read about it in more detail from your recommended book, that is of Lakshmi Kant of Indian Polity. And next is, consider the following pairs of tribes and their states. First, Saharia's Madhya Pradesh. Second, Sentinel's Andhra Pradesh. Third, Konda Reddy's Andaman and Nicobar Islands. And fourth is Cholonaikans, Kerala. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correctly matched. Let me tell you friends that only first and fourth are correctly matched. Basically second and third are not correctly matched, because they are interchanged. So Konda Reddy's are basically in Andhra Pradesh and Sentinels are in Andaman and Nicobar. So the answer is your 1 and 4 only. So the answer is A. So Konda Reddy tribes are present in Andhra Pradesh. So Sentinelese are a Negrito tribe who live in North Sentinel Island of Andamans. So the inhabitants are connected to the Jarawa on the basis of physical as well as linguistic similarities. So their numbers are believed to be less than 150 and as low as 40. So next is consider the following statements about Article 371. First, it is a temporary provision under the Constitution of India. Second, it provides for uniform administrative procedure for the states in which article is implemented. So we have to choose that which of these statements is correct. Let me tell you, friend, that both of these statements are incorrect. So it is not temporary provision, it is permanent provision, and also it doesn't provide uniform administrative procedure. So more detail is in your Indian Polity by Lakshmikant. And next is, which of the following country India has not signed logistics agreement? A, South Korea. B, United States. C, Australia. D, Singapore. So the solution is, friends, C, Australia. So logistic agreement. So India and South Korea concluded a military logistics agreement, and then we also have this such kind of agreement with USA as well as with Singapore also. So since 2016, India has signed military logistics agreements with US, France, Oman and Singapore. So India is looking to conclude 3 military logistics port agreements by the year end with Japan, Australia and Russia. So next is, which of the following countries is not affected by civil war? A, South Sudan. B, Afghanistan. C, Yemen. D, none of the above. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is D, none of the above, because all these countries are affected by civil war in one way or the other. So it causes lot of hardships and loss of life, and it forces many other problems like malnutrition, migration, and a lot of other issues as well. For example, violence against women and children. So next is, Mukurti National Park is present in which of these states? So friends, let me tell you that the answer is D, that is Tamil Nadu. So it is present in Tamil Nadu. So it is basically a protected area located in the northwest corner of Tamil Nadu in Western Ghats. So park was created to protect its keystone species, that is Nilgiri Tahar. So park is characterized by mountain grasslands and shrublands interspersed with sholas in a high altitude area of high rainfall near freezing temperatures and high winds. So it is part of Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. So the park was previously known as the Nilgiri Tahar National Park. So it is home to array of endangered wildlife including Royal Bengal Tiger and Asian Elephant. But its main mammal attraction is Nilgiri Tahar. Next is, Satark, an application for early warning communication system, is developed by which state disaster management authority? A, Odisha. B, Tamil Nadu. C, Gujarat. D, Maharashtra. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is Odisha. So Satark is basically developed by Odisha State Disaster Management Authority, and it is a one-stop climate risk management and decision support portal developed to provide real-time watch, alert and warning information for all hazards in the state of Odisha. So the portal, with the rich database of historical disaster archives, helps in generation of disaster specific profiles at both district and block level. And next is tenth question. Slinax exercises between which countries? I don't know how to pronounce it. Please read yourself. And Indian navies. B, Sri Lanka and Indian Navy. C, Singapore and Indian Navy. D, none of the above. Let me tell you, friends, that the answer is B, that is Sri Lanka and Indian Navy. So basically, it is a bilateral maritime fleet exercise between navies of India and Sri Lanka. So the exercise will commence on September 7, 2019. So exercise features wide ranging naval exercises including helicopter operations. So since 2005-06, such successful maritime exercises have been conducted, and this has helped two navies in understanding each other's procedures and contribute towards maritime security in the region. So friends, this is all about your today's MCQs. Today the MCQs were quite easy. So if you found them easy, then it is good. If you found them difficult, then it is very good, because obviously that means you are preparing. If in case you are finding it very difficult, that means you are making progress, and you have come here to see that whether you know the answers of these questions or not. So obviously, friends, if in case you like this video, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. channel. And lastly, friends, if in case you want to remain updated with our latest initiatives that we undertake, then you can join our public Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen, and this will also be provided in the description box. If in case you have any queries, doubts, then you can mail us at this mail ID, that is achieveias21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at 8968920720. So in case of any queries, doubts, you can ask in comment box, or you can personally contact us if you don't want to ask in the comment box. And lastly, friends, if in case you are interested in the PDF of these daily MCQs, then you can contact us on this mail ID or contact number, and also subscription link will also be provided in the description box. So we have basically kept a minimum fee for the PDFs of these daily current affair MCQs, and it has been kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability and for the purpose of our motivation as well, so that we can remain motivated to help you people. So it is rupees just 99 per month, so you can join by paying that fee if in case you are interested. And lastly, do ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So this is all about today's video. Thank you. Have a very nice day ahead.